Hello, great evening to you over there. This is Anna James, your host of Just the M on PRZ FM 109.2 London. I'm here again and I thank God for your life. Shall we pray? Father in heaven, we want to say thank you so much for your faithfulness and goodness towards us. Thank you, mighty one, for what you have been doing in our lives. Thank you, King of Glory, for what you will do and do and do again, because you are a faithful God. And I always say that you are too faithful to fail. There is no one that trusts in you that you fail. You don't leave nor forsake your own children. And so, Father, we are here again, gathering, O Lord, at your feet to learn, to pray, to ask of you as usual, and even to go and be blessed and be a blessing to other people. Thank you, Father. We give you praise. In Jesus' mighty name. Amen. Hallelujah. Yeah. I believe you are doing well over there. I want you to call your sisters, your brothers, your husband, your wife, children, neighbors, family, relatives. Let them come together. It's time to pray. Like I said before, Anna James, your host on Just the M. From PRZ FM 109.2, London. Today we have a very, very wonderful topic, an important thing that we need in our lives. You need them, I need them. Every home needs them. We are one of that which I'm saying today, a blessing. We have been a blessing in a family. To be a child in a family, you are a blessing. For me to be a child in my family, I am a blessing. And so as much I am a blessing to my family, to God's name, I want children to be a blessing in my own home too. And that is why I've come to us with a prayer title today as None Shall Be Barren. None shall be barren. Hallelujah. I want to read the book of the Lord, Isaiah 54. I want to read verse 7 to 8. If you have your Bible with me, please open to Isaiah 54, verse 7 and 8. He says, "For a brief moment I abandoned you, but with great compassion I will take you back. In a burst of anger I turned my face away for a little while, but with everlasting love I will have compassion on you, says the Lord your Redeemer." Hallelujah. A little while the Lord will take his face. And he says that it's just for a while, which means there may be a delay. Most likely you have been waiting on God for the fruit of the womb. 1 year, 2 years, three, five. We've got testimonies of people that waited more than that and God still answered them. We got people of 10, 20 years. Yours will not be in Jesus' name. But maybe you are believing God for the fruit of the womb today. I mean, you want God to bless your family with children. You want your marriage to be blessed with children, boys and girls. The Lord will always do it because it is his promise. While I brought this scripture is for us to know that for a while, God may take his face away, but it's not a continuous thing. It's not permanent. He won't just take his way away from you, from that which he knows that he promised to give to you. He will give children to you, not even a child. And so we are going to pray today. I just want to take this time to encourage husband and wife. I want to encourage my brothers and sisters. I want to encourage husbands and wife. I want to encourage friends and family. I want to encourage whoever you are that you are a couple today and you are hearing me, listening to me. Be encouraged and still hold on to the Lord. He will do it. He has promised. He has promised. He will never fail. I will follow him. I will follow him. He has promised. He will never fail. His faithfulness is forevermore. His faithfulness is forevermore. You want to talk of Sarah? Sarah was the wife of Abraham. you know, originally called Sarai. She was the first recorded barren woman in the Bible. And if we look into the word of God in the book of Genesis, God answered her. Hallelujah. Even at her old age, God still did it. There is another woman called Manoah in the book of Judges. A man, rather. This man was childless, is with his wife, and it was recorded that they were sterile and childless. But her childlessness was for a purpose. She was to be visited by God through an angel who announced an end to her barrenness. Hallelujah. So, I want us to be encouraged and to understand that whatever comes, like whatever we see coming our way, like a delay, is for a purpose. God has his plan and he has us at heart. When God causes and allow any delay, is because he has a better plan for us. Hallelujah. There was another person, Anna. We've heard of this before many, many times, of Anna's testimony. Anna happens to be Samuel's mother. I always say something that God needed a prophet. Anna needed a child. And until God was ready for a prophet to be given birth to, Samuel didn't come. 1 Samuel chapter 1 verse 11 says, O Lord Almighty, if you will only look upon your servant's mystery and remember me and not forget your servant, but give her a son, then I will give him to the Lord for the days of his life, and no razor will ever be used on his head. This happens to be Anna making a vow unto the Lord. You know, sometimes when you wait and wait and wait and it seems it's not coming forth, you just want to tell God, if you can do this for me, I will do this. Many a times, some of us have made vows that we didn't fulfill, which is not what we should be doing. What we push you to make a vow is the trust you have in God. It's because you believe that he will do it. If you are led to do that, glory be to God. Please go ahead. But make sure that it's something that you can fulfill. Anna promised God that she's going to give Samuel back to him. And she did. Not by his power. It is because it's written. It's a plan that God has in place for Samuel to be his prophet. For Samuel to be a priest in his house. Because it is God that actually needed Samuel to come at that time. You want to talk of Rebecca? Rebecca happens to be the only woman that had a delay. I call it a delay because they later gave birth to children. Rebecca happens to be the only woman in the Bible that the husband stood in gap for. Husbands, are you listening to me tonight? You need to pray for that woman. Don't leave her to pray on her own. Pray together. Pray for her. Wives, pray for your husband. Pray for one another. Agree together. For the word of the Lord says, upon every agreement there shall be an establishment. He prayed for Rebecca's husband, prayed for Rebecca, and God answered. Pray for your wife today. Always pray for her. Wives, pray for your husband. Always pray for him. Pray together. Trust the Lord and he will answer. Rachel happens to be another woman that had a delay. Rachel was recorded to be barren due to Jacob's half measure of love to Leah, her senior sister. What I'm trying to put to us tonight is delay may come for one reason or the other, but that doesn't mean that we are going to be denied. The word of the Lord says there shall not be anyone barren in our land. No one is barren. We are all blessed. Only one woman in the Bible remained barren till she died. and it was because of what happened. I want to believe that, you know, there was other people, the Shunammite woman, Elizabeth, you know, we have them like that. But I just want to jump to this last one so that we go to prayer. Michael, the wife of David, was the daughter of King Saul. As the Bible recorded it in the book of 2 Samuel chapter 6, verse 23. The word of God says, and Michael, Michael, daughter of Saul, had no children to the day of her death. To the day of her death. All the women that I've mentioned, all the men mentioned, were not barren till the day of their death. Only this woman, only King Saul's daughter, only Michal, the daughter of Saul, the wife of David. And what happened was, because she made jest, she spoke wrongly, she defiled the name of God in her husband's life while her husband was praising and dancing unto the Lord for the ark of God that was returned to the land. She ridiculed him. And so God saw it to be a ridicule of his name. For her husband was praising God at that particular time. When one is praising God and seriously praising God from the depth of his or her mind, such person may not know what they are doing. And that was what happened on that day when David was dancing. He danced and danced that he didn't realize that his robe had fell off his body. And his wife saw him and she was so upset. And that was it. That was what made God to curse her. She was the only one that was recorded in the Bible that was barren till the end of his of her life, rather. No one else before her and no one after her. I want you to be encouraged. I want you to trust and believe that he that has promised you will not fail you nor forsake you. He is able. He is more than able. Just keep on trusting in him. Keep on keeping on in him. He will not leave you. He will make that grace sufficient for you to keep you on till the end, that testimony when it comes, none of you, you and your husband, you and your spouse, you and your wife, none of you will be found wanting. You will be alive to witness that testimony. You will be alive to carry your testimony. You will be alive to share your testimony. You will be alive to bless other people with your testimony in the name of Jesus. So tonight, be encouraged and join me to pray. My first prayer point, I want us to lift our voices and thank God. I want you to bless God that you are alive. I want you to give God the praise that you can even reason that you want the fruit of the womb. Many people, they are there, they cannot even think right. I want you to thank God. I want you to bless the name of the Lord that you have that man beside you. You have that woman beside you. You have people praying for you. I am praying for you. Many are praying for you. They are praying with you right now. And so I want you to thank God that you have been remembered. God have not forgotten you, but it is your time. I want you to thank God that it is your time. Your set time to be blessed is now. The set time for your home to be blessed with the sound of joy is now. Your set time to be lifted, your set time to celebrate. The set time for you to jubilate is now. And so I want you to lift your voices and thank God. Lift your voices and begin to appreciate God. Father Lord, I want to thank you so much, oh God. I give you praise for every homes. I bless your holy name for every couples. I thank you so much for every family that you are blessing. Thank you so much for making this time their set time. Thank you so much for remembering them. Thank you, mighty King of glory, for the sound of joy that will begin to be heard, O Lord, even in these families. Father, we are grateful for all your sons and daughters that are blessing you right now. Father, we say thank you. Thank you for blessing them with the fruit of the womb. Thank you for blessing them with children. Father, we glorify you. Blessed be your name, O Lord. In Jesus' mighty name, amen. I want us to lift our voices, that every spiritual gatekeepers or evil gate men that are standing at the gate of your womb or the womb of any of our beloved, someone we know, your sister, your friend, your daughter, your daughter-in-law, I want you to lift your voices and pray that every gatekeeper, every evil gate man standing at the gate of the womb of the one that desire the fruit of the womb right now, that is preventing that conception, be subjected to fire of the Holy Ghost. Lift your voices and pray in the name of Jesus. Lift your voices and pray. Subject those gatekeepers and evil gatemen, subject them to the fire of the Holy Ghost in the name of Jesus. We destroy you. We call you off duty right now. Every gatekeepers, every evil gateman that is standing at the gate of the womb of all the women that desire the fruit of the womb, we put you to nothing tonight. We subject you to the fire of the Holy Ghost in the mighty name of Jesus. Thank you, Father. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. I want us to lift our voices and say, Father, I want to thank you, for if you could answer all those women in the Bible, I know you will answer me. Father, Lord, I lift your name high. For you answer Sarah, you answer Rebecca. Father, Lord, you answer Anna. I know you will answer me. Father, answer me today. Answer me and bless me with the fruit of the womb. Lift your voices. If you are praying for somebody, pray that the Lord will bless that woman. The Lord will bless that man. The Lord will bless those couples with the fruit of the womb. Lift your voices. That the sound of children will be heard in their family. Lift your voices and pray for them. That the Lord will bless their life, even with as many as those children they desire, boys and girls, in the name of Jesus. Father, Lord Almighty, King of glory, if you can do for all those women in the Bible, we believe that you can do, O Lord, even for this couple. We believe you can bless this family with children. Father, we pray in agreement with them. Bless them with children, as many as they desire. Bless them with boys, bless them with girls, O Lord. Bless them with twins, bless them with triplets, in the name of Jesus. As they desire, Father, we are praying that you will bless them in the precious name of Jesus. I want us to lift our voices and decree that every satanic concrete that is preventing the seed of joy to germinate in the womb of every woman that desire, let's lift our voices and begin to break their power. Let's begin to render them useless and powerless right now. Every satanic concrete preventing the seed of joy to germinate in every womb that desire the fruit of the womb, we render you useless. We break you down in the name of Jesus. We take hold of the armor of God. We break you down. We command you to break by fire tonight in the mighty name of Jesus. We break down every concrete that is preventing, every stone that is blocking the wall or the entrance of the seed of children to germinate in every womb. We pull you away. We drag you off. We push you away in the mighty name of Jesus. Thank you, Father. Blessed be your name, O Lord. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Amen. I want us to take this prayer. The next one says, any evil material of the spirit, husband, disturbing my fruitfulness, catch fire now. Let me quickly explain this. I want you to understand that it is another lesson on its own for us to understand the spirit husband and how they operate. But briefly, I want you to understand that as much as we have husband on earth, so there are some demons in the realm of the spirit that what they are sent to do is to block and deny us the fruit of the womb. They don't only deny us of children, they deny us of promotion, they deny the children of God of breakthrough, of progress in life, of peace, of joy, of fulfillment. when they notice any area of a child of God that is pleasant, that is peaceful, that is glorifying the name of God, such spirit comes and cause a delay or cause a barrier. Such, even, you know, you have some terrible dreams that you see them in the dream acting as husband. You see them in the dream acting as wives. In the dream, you know that you have children. In the dream, you know that you have a husband or you have a wife. But in the physical being, children are not forthcoming. Some husband is not, nobody, no man is seeing them. So no woman wants to say yes to them. These are the kind of things I'm talking about. But tonight is not the teaching of spirit husband or spirit wife. It's a demon that you don't want in your life. So I want us to pray. Peradventure, if there be anything of relationship of such in your life, lift your voice this night and say, any evil material of the spiritual husband or spirit husband disturbing my fruitfulness, catch fire right now in the name of Jesus. Any evil material of the spirit wife disturbing me having children, catch fire in the mighty name of Jesus. Catch the fire of the Holy Ghost. I set you ablaze and I destroy you by the fire of the Lord. Lift your voices and pray in the precious name of Jesus. My Father, my Lord, oh Lord, I pray for this family. I pray for this couple. I pray for this woman. I pray for this man. If there be any evil material of the spirit husband or wife that is disturbing their fruitfulness, Lord, I decree and I declare tonight that they will catch fire and be destroyed. Burn, let this be burned to ashes, O Lord, in the mighty name of Jesus. Father, let every barrier be removed. Every barrier be removed. Every obstacle be removed. Every checkpoint that is checking the destiny of this one. Every ground that the enemy is using against them that is causing them this delay. Father, we set it ablaze tonight in the mighty name of Jesus. Any evil deposit of the unholy or ungodly relationship that any one of them had before they got married, Father, let your mercy prevail over it all by the blood of Jesus. Lift your voices and pray that prayer, that any evil deposit of unholy, ungodly relationship that I had before I got married that may be preventing fertility, blood of Jesus, wash it away from me. Wash it away from my life. Wash it away from my husband. Wash it away from my wife. Lift your voices and pray that prayer. Any evil deposit of the unholy, ungodly relationship that any one of you had even before you get married to one another that is preventing your fertility, blood of Jesus, wash it off you, wash it off your life, wash it off your destiny tonight. You are set loose and free to begin to have as many as you desire in the mighty name of Jesus. The Lord will bless your home in Jesus' mighty name. Amen. Some, their delay may not even be anything medical. It may just be an attack. It may just be because of one foundation or the other that they have. I want us to pray. As extra power from both parents preventing us from having our own children, the blood of Jesus, plead the blood of Jesus. Pray that the mercy of the Lord will set you loose and free from every ancestral power that is preventing you. Anything whatsoever that is of your foundation, your parent foundation, or your spouse's foundation, or his or her parent foundation that is preventing you from having your own children, plead the blood of Jesus and seek and have the mercy of the Lord to prevail over judgment tonight in the mighty name of Jesus. Lord Almighty, I join your children to pray. Every ancestral power from both, in the name of Jesus, from both parents, from both family, that is preventing them, that is causing them not to have their own children, Father Lord, let them, oh God, let those power be destroyed. Let them be rendered powerless in the mighty name of Jesus. Everything that is sustaining them, that is suspending them even from being fruitful, in the name of Jesus, Lord, we destroy tonight in the mighty name of Jesus. Father, everything that is preventing them from having the fruit of the womb, whatever they are not preventing, they are not taking any contraceptives, they are not stopping it, they are not calculating, they want these children to come, but something is calculating for them, something is preventing it. Father, Lord, we pray against such power tonight. Let them be destroyed in the mighty name of Jesus. Thank you, Father. In Jesus' name we pray. Next prayer point, we are going to lift our voices and say, any wicked power or personality that has vowed that a baby will not suck my breast. Women, I want you to pray that prayer. Lift your voices and pray that that power is a liar. Is a liar. Whatever wicked power or personality that says your own children will not suck the breast of your your breast. Let's lift our voices and decree that that power is a liar. In the mighty name of Jesus. Reverse and revoke that vow that the enemy might have made against you. Lift your voices, reverse it, revoke it by the power in the blood of Jesus. Revoke it, reverse it in the mighty name of Jesus. Send that decree back to the enemy. Send it back to the sender that you decree to your life that this my breast, baby will suck this my breast. My own children will suck this breast in the mighty name of Jesus. Every negative thing, every negative words that have come out from any wicked power or personality that is denying me of carrying my own children. Today, I reverse your word. I revoke your vows by the power in the blood of Jesus. I revoke it. I reverse it in the precious name of Jesus. The promise of the Lord is that the word of the Lord says none shall be barren. He said children will surround your table. In the name of Jesus. Children will surround your table in the precious name of Jesus. Lift your voices. Lift your voices and pray that prayer. Don't stop. Don't stop praying. Pray for yourself. Pray for your spouse. And if you are here tonight, you are praying for someone, don't stop praying for them, that the Lord will answer their prayer, even as we agree together tonight, that every negative words, even if it's medical, maybe it's your medical report, maybe it's your doctor, maybe it's whosoever is taking care of you medically that is telling you that it's not possible. I am telling you tonight, we serve a God of possibility. He makes every impossibility to be possible. He's going to turn that story around for you, to favor you, to glorify his name. The Lord is going to turn that report around, even to win so to his own kingdom, in the mighty name of Jesus. Your testimonies will call for testimony. Many will hear your testimony. Many will see your testimony and change their heart towards God, in the mighty name of Jesus. Thank you, Father. We bless your holy name. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Amen. The next prayer point, I want us to lift our voices and say, any satanic collection in the air, in the water, on the earth standing against my fruitfulness, break by fire. Break by fire. Pray that prayer for yourself. Pray it for your spouse. Pray it for your sisters and brothers. Pray for your daughters and sons. Any satanic collection in the air. Any satanic collection in the water. Any satanic collection on the heart. Standing against the fruitfulness of every family member that desire children tonight. Break by fire. In the name of Jesus. Break by fire. In the mighty name of Jesus. We subject you to nothing. In the name of Jesus. We render your power useless. We render your power powerless in the mighty name of Jesus. For you have not been given the power to torment any child of God. For they bear upon their body the mark of the living God. Let nothing trouble them. Barrenness, stop troubling every home that desire and they believe and they are praying along with me tonight and trust the Lord for the fruit of the womb. Father, Lord, I pray that the sound of joy will be heard in this family. In the mighty name of Jesus. Any collection that is not of the Lord, every spirit contrary to the spirit of the Lord that is denying you of fruitfulness, I break them by fire tonight in the precious name of Jesus Christ. Thank you, faithful Father. Thank you for answering our prayer. In Jesus' mighty name, amen. You are going to pray again. Any word spoken into my life at infancy, which is now working against my fruitfulness, I gather you together and make you of no effect in my life. In the name of Jesus, lift your voices and pray that prayer. Any word spoken into my life when I was young, which is now working against my fruitfulness, I gather you together and make you of no effect in my life, in my marriage, in the mighty name of Jesus. Lift your voices and pray in the precious name of Jesus. If there be any word, any negative word that has been spoken to my life, to the life of these ones, that is working against them, that is causing them to be not to be fruitful, my Lord, my Father, I am praying tonight in the name of Jesus. Let it not be of any effect over them anymore, in the name of Jesus. Let it not be of any effect over their home, over their marriage, in the mighty name of Jesus. I want you to lift your voices right now and hold your, if you are there, directly praying for yourself. Your spouse is there. I want you to hold one another. I want you to hold one another. Begin to plead the blood of Jesus tonight. The Lord has promised He will not fail. He's a faithful God. He's a good God. He is too faithful. Our Father is too faithful to fail. He's too faithful to fail. Lift your voices. Hold one another and begin to pray right now. Begin to pray for one another. And if you are a mother, is your daughter you are praying for or your daughter-in-law, move closer to them, or your son, move closer to them. There is power in agreement. Let's begin to pray. As many prayer points that I've led tonight, I want you to now pray your prayer the way you want to pray it. In the name of Jesus, lift your voices and begin to pray. As you want to pray your prayer, begin to pray right now. Ask the Lord, be specific. Tell the Lord the sex of the child you want. Tell the Lord, do you want twins? Do you want triplets? Do you want two boys? Do you want two girls? Do you want a girl? Do you want a boy? Tell the Lord. He is faithful. He said we should ask in the name of Jesus, and he will answer us. He will do it for us. He said whatever we decree on earth shall be decreed. Whatever we decree on earth and says should be, will be as heaven will decree it with us. And whatever we decree that should not be, heaven will decree with us that it should not be, because heaven agree with us. Lift your voices and say no to barrenness tonight. Say no to barrenness. Say no to barrenness in the mighty name of Jesus. I join you to say no to barrenness in the name of Jesus. I join you in agreement to call forth children into your family, into your home, into your marriage. Whatever gap that the delay had caused between you and your spouse, we close it up tonight in the mighty name of Jesus. Whatever family trouble, whatever ridicule, whatever pains this delay had caused in your family, today we turn it around to be celebration, to be jubilation for you. Where you have been ridiculed, you'll be celebrated there. And where you have been celebrated, you will not be ridiculed there. Whatever this delay had caused in your life, I want you to lift your voices and pray. Father, I say no to barrenness. I close up every gap that this might have caused between me and my spouse. Pray that prayer in the precious name of Jesus. I want you to begin to jubilate. Jubilate right now. Jubilate and begin to give God the praise. There is excitement in the air right now, because the Lord had released your children unto you. As many as you desire, the Lord will bless your home with good children, with blessed children, with children of excellence, children that will glorify the name of the Lord. Lift your voices and begin to appreciate Him. Give Him glory, give Him honor, give Him adoration. He's a faithful God. He has done it, because He has done it. He did it before. He will always do it, because He's a God of possibility. Father, we are grateful. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord, for everything that you have done. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord, for everything that you have done. Tonight, before I round up, do you want to agree with me that a lot of people, the barrenness they are experiencing in their life is not about the fruit of the womb? It's not about children not being in their home. It's so personal that they know that there is a vacuum in them that needs to be filled. They know, and they are so sure that there is something missing in their life. Are you there tonight listening to me? Is it regarding your career? Is it a financial problem? Do you have children all over the house, but you are not enjoying having them in the house with you? Is there any area of your life where you think God had forgotten you? Is there any area of your life where you feel so empty? You feel so lonely? You feel so neglected? You feel so abandoned? You feel not cared for? I want to encourage you tonight. I want you to know that the Lord will not allow barrenness in your destiny. You are a fruitful man. You are a fruitful woman. You are blessed. You are highly favored. The Lord is on your side. He loves you. He cares for you. He will not leave nor forsake you. He lives in you. and he wants to dwell in you and make life so easy for you. And so tonight I decree to your life, as you agree with me right now, that every space, every vacuum left in you be filled with the presence of the Lord. When Mary asked that angel, said, how will that be? I've never known a man. He said, I'm going to give birth to a child. How will that be? The angel said, when the Spirit of the Lord comes upon you, you will receive power, and it shall be done. When the Spirit of the Lord is upon my soul, I will sing like David sang. When the Spirit of the Lord is upon my soul, I will dance as David danced. I will dance, I will dance, I will dance as David danced. I will dance, I will dance, I will dance as David danced. Hallelujah. I want you to pray tonight for yourself. Holy Spirit, come upon me. I want you to receive fresh oil tonight. I want you to receive the touch of the Holy Spirit tonight to assure you that you are not alone, that the Lord is on your side. Lift your voices and pray that prayer for yourself. Is it about your career, like I said? Is it about your family, your marriage, your finance, your business? Whatever it is. Is it even that about that office? You don't want to go tomorrow because you don't know what will happen. Or about your education? You don't even want to go to that school tomorrow. You don't want to be there. You don't even want to see that person. You don't want to come out of your house. Listen. Just ask the Holy Spirit to come upon you and you will receive power. You will receive boldness. You will receive blessing. You will receive freedom and you will be set loose from every limitation. Lift your voices and receive the Holy Spirit tonight. Our God is faithful, is good, is kind, is mighty, is beautiful. These all good things about your Father and you in his image. I promise you, nothing reduces you from being like God. He loves you. He cares so much for you. And he will not leave nor forsake you because he really, really loves you. Hallelujah. I thank God for your life tonight. And I want you to know that I am praying with you. I will see you again next 2 weeks from PRZ FM 109.2 London. Just the M. And your host again says, God bless you. Anna James. Represent your